What is this weird sounding supplement? I don't take as many supplements as I used to. These are all the supplements that I'm currently taking. It's actually a small portion of what I used to take, but supplements are expensive. Spermidine is definitely one that I take. And here's why. This unique compound has been making waves in the world of health and longevity. It's like a cleaning crew for our cells, improving cardiovascular health, lowering blood pressure, and it's great for our skin since it promotes collagen production. And it might be as effective as fasting when it comes to anti-aging benefits. And I hate fasting, so I was very intrigued when I first heard about this. But is spermidine worth adding to your supplement routine? Let's jump in and find out exactly what it is and does. Spermidine was discovered in 1678 by a Dutch scientist whose name I cannot pronounce.
Van Leeuwenhoek.
He observed a grainy substance in human semen, which he named spermidine due to its origin. However, it wasn't until the 20th century that spermidine's structure and biological functions were fully understood. In the mid-20th century, researchers identified spermidine as a polyamine compound and began exploring its role in cellular processes. Since then, numerous studies have been conducted to investigate the potential health benefits of spermidine, including its effects on longevity, cardiovascular health, brain function, and more. The discovery of spermidine and ongoing research into its various properties have shed light on the importance of this compound in maintaining overall health and well-being. Even though that's how the compound was first discovered, and now we're stuck having to call it by that name, it's thankfully not the only place where spermidine is found. Some foods have good amounts of spermidine in them, but they are not typically foods that I eat often. Aged cheese, wheat germ, certain types of mushrooms. I thought I could either really make an effort to increase the amount of these foods that I eat, or I could take a supplement. I will tell you more about food sources in a bit. So what does it do? Spermidine is a natural polyamine that plays a crucial role in cell growth and rejuvenation. It has been shown to activate a process called autophagy, which is like a cellular spring cleaning. During autophagy, damaged molecules are broken down and recycled, promoting cellular health and longevity. This process is vital in preventing diseases such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. Fasting has been found to be one of the most effective ways to stimulate autophagy. When we fast, our body experiences a temporary nutrient deprivation which triggers the activation of autophagy as a survival mechanism. During fasting, the body breaks down stored fats and cellular debris to provide energy and nutrients for vital functions. Like I already mentioned, fasting is not for me. I really tried incorporating intermittent fasting into my lifestyle because everyone keeps talking about it, but I failed miserably. It just makes me really cranky. Spermidine is a natural compound that can induce autophagy without fasting, which is also great for people who should not participate in fasting for whatever reason. Heart health. Spermidine has also been linked to cardiovascular health. Studies have shown that it can lower blood pressure and it promotes blood vessel flexibility, potentially lowering the risk of heart-related issues. Brain function. Who wouldn't want a boost in brain function? Some studies suggest that spermidine might play a role in supporting cognitive function, improving memory, and protecting against age-related cognitive decline. It does this by improving mitochondrial function in the brain. Basically, it helps to protect brain cells from oxidative stress, keeping your cognitive abilities sharp. Skin and hair. The positive effects of spermidine even extend to our skin. It has been shown to promote collagen production so that we can maintain a youthful and radiant complexion. It can cause hair, skin, and nails to grow faster, which means you're gonna have to get more frequent trims, but that is fine because it also slows down the appearance of wrinkles. Which is never a bad thing, right? In a lab study, exposing scalp tissue to spermidine caused significant percentage of the hair in the shedding phase to move back into the growth phase. And that can lead to repigmentation, which means less gray hair. Bring it on. And potentially also longer and thicker hair. By the way, if you're interested in my routine to keep my hair full and healthy, check out this video when you're done. But finish watching this one first. Anti-inflammatory. Inflammation is at the root of many chronic diseases. The good news is that spermidine has shown promise as an anti-inflammatory agent. By reducing inflammation, it may contribute to a lower risk of conditions like arthritis and other inflammatory disorders. All right, food sources. It is mainly found in plant-based foods like peas and mushrooms, especially shiitake mushrooms, with animal-based foods having lower levels. We can also get spermidine from wheat germ, soybeans, and aged cheese. Natto is a traditional Japanese food made from fermented soybeans. It's super healthy, but the taste is very unique. I'm not a fan. So if you want to boost your spermidine levels and not worry about eating those specific foods, you could consider supplements. The optimal dosage of spermidine has not yet been firmly established. However, studies have suggested that a daily intake around 1 to 5 milligrams may provide potential health benefits, but that is not specific at all. Human trials have shown that 1 milligram of spermidine daily can improve cognition, but no specific study has looked at its standardized dose for hair repigmentation, for example. So I take more than 1 milligram just to make sure I get enough. By the way, it's always best to consult with a healthcare professional before starting any new supplement regimen to determine the appropriate dosage for your specific needs. If you found this video informative, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you feel like it, subscribe. It would mean a lot. Take care.